Hi friends, please like, share, comment and subscribe my channel. Today I am going to take up the fourth unit of applied thermal engineering, that is fourth unit is steam turbines. Now, first, what is a steam turbine? Now, we have already studied in hydraulics and pneumatics in the previous semester, hydraulic turbines. They convert hydraulic energy of water into mechanical energy. Now, these are also similar machines. Here, instead of water, we are using steam of very high pressure. Is fed into these turbines. The boiler generates the steam and the steam is fed into the turbine. The turbine basically is nothing but a wheel mounted on a shaft. It will have vanes or blades. Now, when this high pressure steam with high velocity and pressure, when it enters into the turbine and moves over the blades of this turbine, what happens is the wheel will rotate. Now, that is mechanical energy is created, or we have converted the heat energy of steam into mechanical energy. So, these are prime movers. You can call them as prime movers, which convert heat energy into mechanical energy. Now, basically, this is the principle. Now, these steam turbines, like hydraulic turbines, these are also classified into two types. That is, one is impulse turbine and the other one is reaction turbine. Very similar to what we do in hydraulics. In hydraulic turbines also, we have two types of turbines. One is called the impulse turbine and the other is called as the reaction turbine. Here also similar to that. But in practice, we don't use purely impulse turbine or purely reaction turbine in steam turbines like we do in hydraulic turbines. Now, here we get some theory, that is, you get the compounding of turbines, steam turbine, compounding of steam turbines and different types of compounding. Why compounding is done, what is the necessity of compounding, and what are the different methods, that is, you have pressure compounding, velocity compounding and pressure velocity compounding. These are the three methods of compounding that is employed in the impulse turbine of a steam turbine. Then we get a numerical where there will be a problem on a single stage impulse turbine. We will definitely get a problem of about 10 marks. So, we shall solve these problems. Now, what they will ask us to find is, they ask us to find out the tangential force or tangential force exerted by the steam on the wheel. This can be asked. This is denoted by Fx. Then axial thrust exerted by the steam on the this thing, that is Fy. Then axial thrust, then work done by steam, that is W. Then power generated, P. Then blade, or it is also called as diagram efficiency. So these things So generally, these are the things that we will have to find out, and we use these formulae for them. That is, these are the formulae, Ms into Vw plus or minus Vw1 divided by 1000, so many kilonewton. This will be Ms into Vf minus Vf1 divided by 1000 kilonewtons. W will be Ms into Vw plus or minus Vw1 into small v divided by 1000 kilonewton meters per second, or kilojoules per second. It can be also called as kilojoules per second. Then P will be same formula, Ms into Vw plus or minus Vw1 divided into V divided by 1000. Now the unit will be kilowatt. This will be 2 into Vw plus or minus Vw1 into V divided by capital V square. This, if you want to give it as percentage, into 100. So these are the formulae that we use in solving the problems on steam turbines. Here, in these formulae, Ms means mass of steam supplied to the turbine, in kg per second. It is also called as discharge. Now, this capital V, this one, capital V means it is the absolute velocity of steam, at entrance of the turbine in meter per second. Now small v is called blade or vane velocity in meters per second. This can be calculated using the formula pi dn by 60, where d is so many meters per second. D is dia of runner, it is called, in meters, and N is speed of runner in RPM. This is small v. Vw is called velocity of whirl in meters per second. Now this velocity of whirl is nothing but horizontal component of capital V at inlet. This is at inlet, velocity of whirl at inlet, and Vw1 is velocity of whirl at exit or outlet in again meters per second. Vf is called velocity of flow at inlet in meters per second. That is, it is vertical component of v, and Vf1 is again velocity of flow at exit or outlet in meters per second. So these are the symbols that are used here. Now these things, this will be given directly. Now these things, this will be given, the absolute velocity of steam at inlet or entrance or inlet, this will be given directly. This will also be generally given, or if it is not given, they will give D and N, we can find it out. But these things have to be found out by drawing what we call velocity triangles. In hydraulic turbines, we draw two separate velocity triangles. One is called the inlet velocity triangle and the other one is called as the outlet or exit velocity triangle. But in the case of steam turbines, we draw both inlet and outlet velocity triangles in the same figure. Now, these values that I have given here can be found out either by graphical method or by analytical method. Your syllabus says that you should solve it by only graphical method. Your syllabus says these problems on steam turbine should be solved only by graphical method, they say. Now, I will just explain you how to do it, both analytical as well as graphical method I will show. You can solve the problem by graphical method and you can check whether you have got the correct answers by using the analytical method. Analytical method is more accurate, you can do it. Now I will discuss how to draw the velocity triangles and how to find out what are the things that are there to be found out. See, what we do here is first draw a horizontal line. This graphical method, draw a horizontal line. If you are doing it by graphical method, you have to select a scale. You can select any scale. Now, for example, I will take a problem like this. Say capital V is 900 meters per second. Let us say small v is 300 meters per second. Alpha, that is nozzle angle at inlet, is 20 degree, something like this is given. Let us say in one problem they have given like this. Now I can select a suitable scale. Now scale is in my this thing. I will take 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters per second. So this will be represented by 9 centimeters and this can be represented by 3 centimeters. Because this is 300 meters per second, it will be 3 centimeters. Because this is 900 meters per second, it will be 9 centimeters. I have selected a scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters per second. Now, what I do is, on this horizontal line, mark a distance of, say, this is 3 centimeters. So, this is small v. In some books, they call it as u. Different symbols are used. You can stick to one particular symbol. So this is V. It is 3 centimeters on the figure, but it represents 300 meters per second as per the scale chosen. Next, what I do is, this V is to be drawn. Now, the angle between capital V and small v is 20 degree. That is called as the nozzle angle. Alpha is called as the nozzle angle. This is generally given in the problem. So what I do, either this side or you can do it this side also. This side you can do inlet velocity triangle, that side outlet velocity triangle, or you can do the inlet velocity triangle that side and outlet velocity triangle this side. Now, this from here, draw a line inclined at 20 degrees. This is 20 degree because this alpha is given as 20 degrees. On this line, mark capital V. Capital V is 900 meters. So this is capital V. This is the velocity with which the steam enters the turbine. the steam is entering the turbine with this much velocity into the turbine. So mark this 9 centimeters here. Now what you do, you join this and this, this point to this point. This is the vectorial sum of this V and this V, vectorial sum of V and V. That Vr is called relative velocity at inlet, at inlet in meters per second. That is the resultant of these two, that is Vr. Now from this point, drop a perpendicular onto this, drop a perpendicular onto this line, this horizontal line that we have drawn, drop a perpendicular on that. Now this is the horizontal component of capital V, and this is called VW. VW is velocity of will. I have given you there. VW is the velocity of will at inlet, and this is the vertical component of V, capital V. So this is called as VF. Now this is called theta is called vane or blade angle at inlet. They will ask you to find out this. So what you have to do, keep your protractor here, measure that angle and give the value of theta, that is vane angle at inlet. Now what you do is you measure this length, whatever is the length. Suppose that is 8, this is 8.4 centimeters. Now multiply it by this scale 100. You have taken 1 centimeter as 100, so 8.4 centimeters means it will be 840 meters per second. Measure this VF, find out its length. Let us say it is 3.2 centimeters. Now 3.2 into 100, that will give you 320 meters per second. So you got this. Measure this line, length of this line, again multiply it by this scale, you will get the value of Vr. Now this is called the inlet velocity triangle. This triangle is called as inlet velocity triangle. There are 7 quantities here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is alpha. Alpha, including alpha, there are 7 quantities. 3 will be known to you. You will be given with 3 directly or indirectly, they will give 3 quantities. The remaining 4 quantities, that is this one, generally these 4 quantities, you will have to find out. This is the method of finding it out. I will repeat it once again. Draw a horizontal line, mark small v, blade velocity, on that horizontal line. Keep the protractor here. Whatever alpha is given, it will be usually 18 degree, 20 degree, 22 degree, something like that. That is called nozzle angle at inlet, or nozzles are inclined at so many degrees, they will say. So mark that, keep the protractor here, mark that angle, draw a line like this. On that line, you mark the distance equal to this, so many meters per second, that is capital V, according to your scale. You measure it and mark it, join this point to that point, that is Vr, draw a perpendicular to this line. This is Vf, this is Vw, and this angle is theta. You measure that theta and write it. So this is inlet velocity triangle. This is how it should be solved graphically. Then it is we have to draw the outlet velocity triangle. Now in outlet velocity triangle, this angle is called as phi. This phi is vane angle at exit. Vane angle at exit or outlet in degrees. These angles will be all in degrees. So this angle will be given. they will say it is directly, that can be told as it is so many degrees, or they will say the blades are symmetrical. If they say the blades are symmetrical, that means phi is same as theta, or they may say it is 3 degrees less than theta, something like that they will give. Directly or indirectly it will be given. So this will be known. You keep the protractor here, mark this angle and draw a line like this. Then if they haven't said anything, if they haven't said anything, if VR1 by VR, VR1 is the relative velocity at outlet, this is relative velocity at inlet, VR1 is relative velocity at outlet. If they haven't said anything, it is equal to 1, it is equal to 1, or VR1 is equal to VR. Otherwise they will say if this ratio is 0.8, 0.9 something, or they will say there is 20% loss, frictional loss, or 10% frictional loss, whatever is there. If they say 10% frictional loss is there, then VR1 by VR is 0.9, 90%. Otherwise it is 100%. So if nothing is said in the problem, if nothing is said in the problem, we can take VR1 as equal to VR. So you keep take the compass, draw an arc like this of this radius to cut it somewhere here. So this will be VR1. If nothing is said, if something is said, this becomes shorter, a little shorter than that. Then join this to this. This is V1, capital V1. V1 is the absolute velocity of steam at exit, at outlet. With that velocity, it is discharging outside the turbine. So that is this thing. If you extend this line, this horizontal line further like this, and draw this thing, this gives you, this is VF1 and this is VW1. VW1, this angle is called beta. Beta, that is nozzle angle at exit. So these things will be given. Now this triangle here, this triangle is called as the exit velocity triangle, that is called as exit velocity triangle. Okay, now the in steam turbines, both exit and this thing, you can have the inlet this side and exit that side, no problem. So these things have to be found out. If VW1, this point comes outside this line, then VW1 is positive. If supposing VR1 is this much, then V1 will be like this. If it comes within this line, then it will be called as VW1 will be taken as negative. You will have to draw these lines, measure these lines, again convert them into scale, you will get it. So this should be drawn to scale. This is called as the graphical method of solving the velocity triangles. You have this method only is prescribed, and you have to follow that only in the examination. You have to do it by graphical method only. But you can do one thing, you can do it by another method, that is called as the analytical method. If you do it by analytical method, what you can do is you can compare whether your answers are right or not. To do it by analytical method, you should know that three trigonometric functions, that is sine, cos and tan. You should know sine is opposite by hypotenuse, cos is adjacent by hypotenuse, and tan is opposite by adjacent. If you know these three relationships correctly, the three trigonometric ratios correctly, you can solve it analytically. You can do it analytically, but not for the examination purpose. For examination purpose, you have to do it by graphical method only, to get, just to compare the answers, to know the, whether the answers are correct or not. You can do it this way also. I will just show you how to do it analytically. See, if you are doing it analytically, if you are doing it analytically, what you do is simply draw a rough figure without any scale, without any scale, or you have drawn this diagram, you mark these points. This is how the inlet velocity triangle is. Our inlet velocity triangle is like this. This is our inlet velocity triangle. This is V. This we know. This is capital V. This is alpha. This is theta. This is VR. This is VW. And this is our VF. So this is our inlet velocity triangle. Now what I do here, I'll give some name here, A, B, C, D. You can give any name. You can give P, Q, R, L. Any name can be given. Some name I have given, A, B, C, D. Now, A, B, C is a right angle triangle. In triangle A, B, C, I know this angle, I know this side, I know the hypotenuse, this is the hypotenuse, this is, and this angle I know, it's a right angle triangle I know. Now, you know, opposite by hypotenuse, that is VF by VW is sine alpha, so VF will be equal to, VF by V opposite by hypotenuse. VF by V is sin alpha. So VF is equal to V into sin alpha. Now I know V. V I have taken, for example, I have taken 900 meters per second simply into sin of 20 degrees. So if you use this calculator now, if we use the calculator, we get it. 900 multiplied by sin of 20 degrees. So it is 307.8 meters per second. Now in graphical method, you will not get this much accurately. This is very accurate method, 307.8. There you will either get it as 300 meters per second, or you will get it as 310 meters per second. So some, it will be, you will not get in between 300 and 310, because your scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters per second. You cannot get this accurately there, but if you have got very close to this, 300 is also okay, 310 is also okay. It should be okay with us. Then this is sine. VW by V, this is adjacent by hypotenuse, so this is cos alpha. So VW will be equal to V into cos alpha, that is 900 into cos 20, 900 into cos 20, 900 into cos 20 degree will be equal to 845.7 meters per second. Now again, you will not get 845.7 in graphical method. You will get it as either 840 or 850 meters per second. So this I have got here as 845.7. If you get it close to that, that means it is okay. These are the values that I got. Now next, what I do, I will find out this theta. How I will find out that theta? See, theta will be equal to, see here, this is again a right angle triangle, this one, BDC. In triangle BDC, you know, tan theta is opposite by adjacent. So theta will be equal to tan inverse of opposite. Opposite is this one, that is tan inverse of Vf by this one. This is Vw minus V. Vw minus V. Tan inverse of Vf by Vw minus V. Vf is 307.8 divided by, this will be 845.7 minus 300 means 545.7 equals 307.8 divided by 545.7 equals, I got something 0.564 something, tan inverse of that, shift tan, answer equals, I got it as 29.4 degree. Now this is the value of theta, but you will not get 29.4 here, you will get it as 30 degree. If you get it as 30 degree, it is okay. Next, I have to find out this Vr. Now, in that triangle, you know, this is hypotenuse. Vf by Vr is sin theta. I have got the value of theta. So, Vr will be equal to Vf divided by sin theta. That is, Vf is how much? 307.8 divided by sine of 29.4 degree. If I do 307.8 divided by sine of 29.4 will give me 627 meters per second. Here you will not get 627, you will get either 620 or 630. You can compare it. If once you compare that, if it is correct, you can go through it. Then you have to make substitution for those values in the formula which I gave you earlier for finding axial thrust, tangential thrust, axial thrust efficiency, diagram efficiency, power, etc. like that. Now similarly, now you can draw the exit velocity triangles. This is phi, this is Vr1, this is V1, this is Vw1, this is Vf1, this is beta. You can find out these values. Again, this is a right angle triangle. This is a right angle triangle. Whatever you want, you can find out the same way. Only three trigonometric ratios you must know very clearly. That is, in any right angle triangle, sine is opposite by hypotenuse, cos is adjacent by hypotenuse, and tan is opposite by adjacent. If you know that, you can do it. I hope you have understood this and you are able to follow it. If you have any problem, any difficulty, you can always contact me and clarify your doubts. I once again request you to subscribe to this channel.